And Jerry Stackhouse with a game winner.
Gives it back to Stackhouse.
Coming in at 9, Utah's Mark Jackson offers up this prayer.
And Jackson, before the end of the quarter, fires it.
Oh, mama! Unbelievable!
In at number 8, we catch the flight of Air Canada, Toronto's Vince Carter.
Carter at the foul line. All the way.
Oh, back with a right-handed monster jam! He just posterized Tim Duncan.
In at number 7 is another high-wire rat from the Nets, Richard Jefferson.
Cross court. Jefferson had Jackson leaning.
Oh! He dunked it over the Sterovich. That is a foreign facial.
He threw it over the top of the Sterovich. Climbed the ladder for Richard Jefferson.
At number 6, Cleveland's Ricky Davis sends it down on Detroit.
Oh, he threw it down.
Holy cow!
Look at this. Now he elevates outside of the paint, floats to the basket.
At number 5, the Warriors' dazzling duo of Gilbert Arenas and Jason Richardson.
Knocked away by Arenas. Ahead to Jason. Look out! Oh, my goodness! They're standing in the arena on that one.
In at number 4 is the Knicks' Shandon Anderson, taking it high to the hoop.
Trying to go coast to coast.
Got it!
Oh, man. Fearless.
At 3 is Suns rookie Amari Stoudemire with his own rim rocker.
Stoudemire and 1, and the rookie powers to the rack. Oh, my.
In at number 2, Jason Kidd performs some magic against Orlando.
Chamber with the ball fake. Driving behind the back. Oh, that is gorgeous. Aaron Williams with a dunk. Jason Kidd eyes in the back of his head.
And at number 1, it's this incredible finish between the Suns and Nuggets.
Marbury, Marriott gets it a hold with 0.6 seconds to go. All he's got pass. Bowen, he gets it at the buzzer.
They won the ball game by allowing a long pass.
Let's get down, roll with the hardcore funk, the hardcore sound. Let's get with this Macadocious funk material, so simple. When I rock with the instrumental, who am I?
Indeed, the Green Eyed Bandit.
Control my career so I can never get stranded. Crossover.
All year, the Blazers have made headlines for the wrong reason. The police blotter. The jail Blazers, trail gangsters. They've been dragged through the media mud and called every name in the book. So what's there to talk about now? They're just doing their job, winning ball games. Since Damon Stoudemire and Rasheed Wallace were cited in Washington State for possession of marijuana in November, Portland has blazed their way to a 26-10 record, tied for the best in the NBA with the Dallas Mavericks. Coincidentally, that's right around the time that Coach Mo Cheeks put offseason point guard acquisitions Antonio Daniels and Jeff McGinnis on the back burner, handing the reins of the team to 37-year-old Scottie Pippen. Since moving to the point, he's looked like the Scotty of old. And for the first time since he arrived in Portland 4 seasons ago, this is finally Pippen's team, and it is showing in the win column. Pippen's the perfect point guard for Portland because the Blazers have good passers at most positions, so it's not necessary for the point guard to create shots with penetration. All the team needs from Pippen is a steady hand, a good shooting percentage on open looks, and solid defense. Pip has provided all 3.
Portland is the best team in basketball, right up there with the Lakers right now. Those 2 squads out in the West, they are the hottest and the toughest team to beat. Portland very deep, and Scottie Pippen the reason why.
Portland's post-game brawl with the Warriors in December resulted in a 2-game suspension for Bonzi Wells and a fine for Wallace. But on the court, the Blazers maintained their fire, winning that game on Sheed's buzzer beater, then proceeding to rip off 4 more wins in a row. Wallace got back into hot water in January, threatening a referee outside the Rose Garden. which drew the longest suspension ever for a non-physical altercation, 7 games. So how did the Blazers respond? They won 5 of the 7. Coming out of the break, there are no arrests, no suspensions, just ball games to be played. The Blazers are locking down a first-round home court advantage and don't count on history repeating itself when it comes to a playoff collapse. They're the only team this year with wins at Sacramento, Dallas, and San Antonio. And they're making headlines once again, this time on the court.
Go, go.
Stop. Michael Curry is back on the floor. Mashburn in his hands and trying to win it like he did last night. Robinson digs in, a screen. Phillips on a switch, picks him up. Robinson helps out. Wesley's open. Mashburn's got to hurry. Forced it. Oh, my goodness. 0.2 seconds left. What an incredible shot by Mashburn.
Fred again, they got the floor.
His tips can't get it. Robinson stolen by Wells. Wallace. Blazer lead at 23-15. Rob for Wallace.
Pass intended for a cutting Quinto Woods. Patterson with a steal in the dunk. How about that? He gets 6 fouls on Howard. Zebo trying to get it to Rasheed. 5 to shoot. AD for 3. Yeah! Big time triple by Antonio Daniels. And Stoudemire in the backcourt. Wallace screens for Damon, who turns the corner. An open jumper. It's in!
And the guy, and they get a steal from Patterson.
Patterson in front of the crowd. Blazers a 5-point lead. It's their largest of the night, and it comes with...
He is everywhere now. Reuben Patterson everywhere. Stoudemire.
In and out. There's Captain Chaos. Patterson with a stick back.
Patterson, you got a game.
Rasheed Wallace, a big pro wrestling fan.
You know, they were starting to slide as the quarter came to a close. 13 comes down to 8. Then it
rebound by Christie. Out to Jackson. Trying to tie with a 3. Good! He banked it in! We are tied at 118.
Oh, my God. I was just going to say, that's a terrible shot. 104, you got plenty of time to get the 3-pointer, but the guy is not afraid. You got to give him credit.
Bibby for the lead. Well off the mark. Clark for the lead. Good! With 0.4 to play. 126-124. The Sacramento Kings on a Keon Clark putback.
5 seconds. Stockton looking. Stockton with 3. Stockton, leaner. Tipped in. Rolls down.
Oh my gosh. Karolinko, I think, got a hand on it.
At the buzzer. The Utah Jazz once again walk out of the Meadowlands with a win.
It's a hex. Karolinko gets a hand on it right there. And boy, that ball looked like it wanted to come out, and somehow it found the bottom. And the Nets are burned once again here at the Meadowlands by the Utah Jazz. What is that, 8 in a row?
For the second time this season, Utah has beaten the Nets basically with an offensive rebound. In regulation,